So water balloons are pretty fun to play with, right? I mean, you just fill them with water, you can throw them up in the air, bounce them on the ground. They jiggle a lot, which is funny, but what they're really meant for is... So here we have a small little stockpile of water balloons. We're gonna do some things with them and see if we can get some interesting results. So first we're gonna start with just taking a balloon and just simply popping it. Now, a water balloon popping seems pretty basic, but perhaps we'll see something interesting when we do it. So popping a water balloon is like fun and all, but you have to admit, one of us is gonna have to get hit. It's gonna be you, right?
No.
It's not gonna be me.
It's gonna be you.
Go get a swimsuit on. That's better. You don't have to worry about your clothes getting wet. So, where do you want to get hit? Face, chest, stomach?
Maybe like here.
Chest, neck area?
Yes.
All right,
so do
it.
Be better.
Okay, so I've got my weapon, water balloon. And I've got what's known as a pickle switch, which I don't know why it's called pickle switch, but it basically allows me to remotely activate the high-speed camera. Ready? Cold? So now we're going to upgrade to a bigger water balloon, which I guess you could call party balloon. I don't know, it's bigger. More water. I'm gonna tie it to this to make it a little bit easier. Okay. All right. So we're gonna be running 1500 frames per second just to give it a try. Grace is gonna pop it this time. So go ahead whenever you're ready. So I decided to let Grace get me back for throwing a water balloon at her, and she's gonna drop a full big balloon right on my face. Should be fun. Maybe cold, I don't know. Here we go. Ready?
Yep. You ready?
Kind of. 3, 2, 1.
Oh, what?
Okay, so that one wasn't that good. It's kind of funny though, but we're gonna do it again. I hope it pops this time. Yep, gonna hold it much higher. 3, 2, 1. that was like...
Your hair's
like... I could not hear for a good 10, 20 seconds. That was weird.
You look goofy.
Yeah, I guess. Well, that was pretty cool, but for our finale, we're going to use, what would you call these things?
Punching balloon?
Punch balloon?
Punch balloon.
Let's call it punch balloon. We'll use one of these, connect it to the hose, and fill it until it pops. What color do you think we should use?
We should use red.
Red?
Yeah.
All right. We have no idea how long this is gonna fill before it pops. So I'm gonna use the pickle switch again, and just wait until it pops. So this has been filling for a good 5-7 minutes. It feels like plastic. Oh. Yeah, sounds kind of weird too. So this has been filling for a long time. So I figured, let's make it a little more cool and just jump on it, see what that looks like. Well, we've popped all of our balloons, so let's go take a look at some of the footage. So this is the part of the episode where we bring up our footage, take a look at it, and talk some science. Okay, so first we're going to start out with our slowest frame rate we did, 1500 frames per second, and work our way up. And as we take a look, probably the first thing you'll notice is that after the water balloon pops, the water sort of stays there in a spherical shape for quite a bit of time. And that's due to the gravity around it not being able to pull it quickly enough after this rubber moves out of the way. And seeing it in slow motion sort of emphasizes how long that takes.
Alright, and as we watch this at a slower frame rate, when the balloon pops, you can see the rubber pulls across the water and actually pulls droplets off.
And that's mostly due to the surface tension of the water clinging to the rubber, and as this rubber moves away at such a high velocity, the water can't stay there, and so it basically just gets ripped off and flung into the air. And as we watch this slower still, this being 5,000 frames a second, you begin to see much more detail about what happens as this pops. And we could probably actually use this frame rate to calculate exactly how long it takes. So what we'll do is we'll start at the first frame, we'll count forward to see how many frames it took. So I'm getting about 30 frames for this to happen, and since we know that this shot is 5,000 frames a second, we know that each frame is 1/5,000th of a second, which in decimal form is 0.0002. And we have 30 of these frames, so it's basically just simple multiplication, which ends up being about 1/170th of a second, which is pretty fast. So let's remember that number so we can compare it later. And now we're watching this at the slowest frame rate that we took of these water balloons, which is 10,000. 400 times slower than normal. You can see so much detail about what's happening here.
After that, Bryce unfairly chose to throw a water balloon at me to see what it looks like in slow motion.
I didn't want to get wet, so it was you. So let's play this through at 1500 frames a second. And you can see that as the balloon comes in contact with your chest, it sort of stretches out quite a bit, because the balloon has some amount that it can play with stretching-wise before it actually pops. And you can see that it hits that point right about here, and that's when it begins to tear.
Do you see that ripple that just goes across my skin?
Yep, right there, as it moves like...
The water covers it up later.
Yeah, the edge of the balloon, if you watch, there's a ripple
right there
that travels up your shoulder. And that's just the dispersion of force from the water balloon itself. And I can't help but notice how much that actually looks like one of those commercials where they wash their face off, splash their face with the water from the sink. That's kind of what it looks like right there. Although the person in the commercial would be much more happy than you are right now.
Yeah.
After the small balloon, we wanted to see how a larger balloon would act when popped. And this is one of the party balloons, I guess. I guess that's what it's called. Not really meant for water balloons, but we made it. And I had Grace pop it this time, so I could man the camera. Seeing it at 1500 frames per second, you can see the shape of the water after the rubber leaves. It's almost like a tear shape. Must have been really sad.
You know, just like earlier in one of the red balloons, you see that the rubber pulls the water in two different directions.
Yeah, this one actually made like a jet going up and a jet going down. And there's like this circle around it that's just calm water, because that's where the rubber actually divided and wasn't really moving in any direction. That's still pretty interesting. And slower still, at the 5,000 frames per second, you can see how the tear is moving in the opposite direction of the red balloon. So the red balloon went from the knot to the other end of the balloon, and this one's actually just going around it. That's pretty interesting. And at the whopping 10,000 frames per second, zoomed up much closer. You can really see how the tear moves across the surface of the balloon. So Grace decided to get some revenge on me, and I had to lay on the ground while she dropped the balloon on my face. And as you saw, she got to do it two times, just because this first balloon wouldn't pop. But yeah, here it is at 2,500 frames per second.
What's this?
Yes, and Grace is pointing out that you can see a ripple going down the side of my face. Yeah, you can see how the force from it hitting my face sort of travels out and then up and around the balloon, and you can see all these like ripples going up towards the top of it. And then it bounces off and didn't pop until it hit the ground. So that was a fail.
But you just loved that.
No.
You know how dumb you are? Many.
Many amounts. If dumbness was a thing, you'd be many of them. Okay.
What do you call this? Blue?
You're making fun of yourself. You really are. That was not me. Okay, so since that balloon didn't pop, Grace had the opportunity to go again. And you can see that I'm tensing up a lot. My head actually lifted from the ground. And when this water balloon comes down and hits me, you can see my head moves down much faster. And it kind of hurt. And you can see a ripple going through my hair and my skin. You can make fun of me, Grace.
Your yes. nose is like it smacked yes. your
yep. it probably did. But yeah, it's interesting how this basically just morphs around my head and face for a while. And then it stretches out to the point where it just the rubber can't handle it anymore. And it just explodes. And water just goes everywhere.
See, when I dropped that, it looked like you hit your head pretty hard against the ground. I thought you'd have a headache.
I don't even remember if I did or not.
I remember. You didn't.
It was just so much water. That's all I remember. And then I've got a little hat on my nose.
Nose hat. Nice.
Yeah. My hairdo's a little bit different now. So after all of that, we went and found a much larger balloon, which I think you call a punching balloon.
Yeah.
Is that what it's called?
Yeah.
Okay. So I originally wanted to fill this until it exploded, but that was just taking way too long. So I had the idea of having Grace jump on it, just to see how much more interesting it would look, and it actually looked a lot cooler. So here it is at 2,500 frames a second.
I'd be able to feel it when I jumped on it, like I'd be suspended in the air for a little bit, like on top of the balloon.
Sort of like bounce and then explode?
Yeah, but that didn't happen. I jumped and it just exploded. It's like a normal jump on the ground.
It seems like you would feel all this resistance because you're moving so much water out of the way. You actually see like all these contortions and stuff, but I guess it makes sense because you're just pushing the water away and it's not really pushing up, especially at this point because the rubber's gone. And so the water doesn't have any form, so it's just free to just drop.
And if you notice, my feet were about halfway through the balloon when it actually popped.
Which is right here. Yeah, you're most of the way down the balloon. About halfway, yeah. And then this end part right here, when it first pops, sort of like tears in half. So that was the last clip we did for this video on water balloons. Feel free to subscribe to get new videos every week. And we're gonna go have a water balloon fight now. Thanks for watching this week's episode of High Speed Fanatics. You can follow us on Twitter at username HighSpeedFans.
You can also find us at facebook.com/highspeedfanatics.
If you have any questions or suggestions, please feel free to send us an email at highspeedfanatics@gmail.com.